while Afghanistan falls apart. So either it's a way of covering their incompetence, or it is incompetence that they're spending so much time on this social welfare agenda and wokeness that they can't do their job.
What's happening in recruitment? I don't know if you know the answer, but I have two questions. One, are they meeting?
I'm worried about it like you are.
Yes. So here are my two worries: numbers, and what will the ratio be, male female?
Well, those are good units, because let's just put off the table race and gender for a moment and just ask ourselves, what particular group is dying inordinately in Afghanistan and Iraq on the front lines the last 20 years? And that happens to be white males from the middle class. About 75% of the fatalities on average in those two wars came from that group. And what is the group that General Milley and Chief of Naval Operations Gilday and Secretary of Defense Austin are saying are suspect for insurrectionary activity and they need to be hounded out? It's that group. And so when Secretary Austin says, I want a proportionally represented military, and I'm going to make sure that the military looks like the United States, you want to say to him, well, what does that entail? Do you mean the dead are going to look like the United States? Because they really don't right now. The dead are overwhelmingly white males from the middle and rural classes. And yet those are the very, that's a source of recruitment that you have relied on to fight your wars in combat units. So you're alienating or disparaging or caricaturing a group for cheap political gain. And is that group going to continue to volunteer to go over to godforsaken places like Afghanistan? And by the way, we're not talking about quotas. We don't believe that you identify people by race, but these people do, Dennis. They do. And yet, if they're going to do that, they're going to be hoisted by their own petard, because it's suicidal. They're alienating the very rubric in their way of thinking, and they do classify people by gender and race.
So what's in it for Mark Milley to be woke?
What's in it for him?
Yes.
Well, I'm not trying to disparage him, Dennis, but he's not an impressive character, and yet he's the iconic leader of the U.S. military. And yet he leaks confidential conversations to muckraking journalists on the left. He violates the Uniform Code of Military Justice by comparing his commander-in-chief to Hitler. He calls up a Chinese counterpart in the PLA, or he interrupts the chain of command contrary to the law of the advisory purview of the Joint Chiefs. So he's done everything wrong. How did he get there? And what does he want when he leaves? I think what he knows is that the fact that he's positioned himself as somebody who made fun of Trump about the photo op, even though the Secretary General, the Inspector General of the Interior Department, said there was nothing wrong, there was no tear gas. But he's positioned himself as an antagonist to Trump. He knows the corporate boardroom is left-wing. He knows the media will rally around him, as they have. Mm-hmm. And I think when he retires, he's going to follow the last few chief staff of the Army or chairman of naval operations or four-star Air Force generals and even Secretary of Defense. He's going to go right to Raytheon or Northrop or Lockheed or General Dynamics, and he's going to be very wealthy. But he knows if he were to criticize wokeness, mm-hmm, mm-hmm, or to be praised for winning Afghanistan at the expense of not being woke, he wouldn't.
Well,
I can be that reductionist.
Yeah, no, it makes sense. He has everything to gain and nothing to lose.